Yeah, the sun is going down, but I'm trying to take you high.
Welcome to Vibrations, fam. Thank you guys so much for your love and support. For those of you that are new to the channel, welcome, baby. If you are interested in booking your own personal reading, you can do that at the website, Divinely Me. Make sure y'all check out our events, because we definitely have some Halloween specials going. And if you stay tuned to the end, you will actually get to see a little clip from one of our Halloween special readings that we are doing. And it is with one of our custom spreads, the Witch's Brew. So if you guys are interested, if any of that message applies to you, make sure you head over to the website. You can check that out starting Saturday at 9 a.m. Central Standard Time, baby. Yes. We got a couple videos for you guys. If you guys are interested in just watching some videos that you don't have to pay for, you can check that out at our channel on divinelyme.com. It is Divine Soul Session Uncut. We got a video there for y'all for the Halloween special as well. So make sure you check out both channels over on the website and partake in that tomorrow. If you guys are interested in our Oracle deck, tarot decks, head over to the website. We also have our divination board. We also got books. We have incense. Check it out, boo. Sage as well. All right, so let's get into your vibrations, shall we? First song up, Kevin Gates, Find You Again. Yeah, who looking for you? Got my popcorn. So somebody's been looking for you, okay? Maybe y'all lost contact with each other, but for some of you guys, this person, they've been trying to find you, okay? Somebody's got some type of information, or somebody wants to talk to you about taking the next step, okay? For some of you guys, this is a new beginning that somebody is looking forward to. Now, for some of you guys, you may even be realizing that you've outgrown a situation, or maybe you outgrew this person. So therefore, you disconnected and you moved away from the relationship. Now this person is searching their soul and they're starting to realize that a part of you has something to do with their spiritual journey, okay? Or there's a need for them to find you. We're going to definitely take a look, okay? Because the next song, you got Zen. So this person is definitely looking for some type of peace. Okay, looking for you or finding you is going to bring this person some type of peace. Oh, plus, shawty. Okay. So they got your back. Somebody could be dating a police officer, or the police could be significant to this situation. Soon as they seen you, they said they paid for it. Oh my. Okay. Okay, so you're dealing with somebody who... this person could have been very inconsistent, not a wise type of energy, okay? Not really wanting to commit to the relationship. You, this person, shawty, okay? This person definitely don't have a problem with spending money on you, buying you whatever it is that you want, okay? Especially when it comes to entertainment. For some of you guys, a lot of the time that you spent in the relationship with this person, you guys could have definitely went out. You guys could have eaten out. Okay, food could be very significant between you and your person. This person is very protective of you, okay? This is somebody who will definitely go up to bat for you. This is somebody who will fuck somebody up about you, okay? Now, whoever you're dealing with, this person is emotionally scarred. Somebody is also going to get some type of message. And again, I told you this person misses you, baby, little baby. So you tried to forget him. Okay. So you or this person could be emotionally scarred. Okay. Somebody could feel rejected. This person could have put themselves out there, and then maybe you close the door in this person's face, or this person could have closed the door in your face. So I feel like the way somebody is dealing with something is that Page of Cups energy being very immature. This could even be the way the two of you communicate with each other. Now, whoever you are or this person is, somebody... you live kind of, and this could even be like a secluded area, or you like your privacy when it comes to the home sector. Not a lot of people know where it is that you live or you lay your head. Okay. Somebody's also posing. Now, I do feel as if communication, that throat chakra, for some of you guys, you may need to clear your throat chakra. There could even be some type of conversation that you are needing to have. Somebody is also born in 1993. I do feel as if when it comes to universal consciousness, a lot of people are waking up to something new. So this person, they lost contact with you. They had to find themselves. You could have felt like this person was playing games. You may have felt like this person was very inconsistent in and out. And it's like this person is finding themselves, and now they're wanting to connect with you. Now they're realizing that they're missing something in their life, and that something happens to be you. But it's like this person, they're looking for you to try to establish some type of peace within the relationship. Because they're coming towards you in this peaceful state. For some of you guys, this person could be trying to find you on social media, could be trying to do any type of Google searches. So the side effects of this entire situation, it's made you unapologetic about your belief system, you being successful, you feeling a sense of victory, you exploring life and having fun. It came with a lot of lessons, okay? Some of you guys, this person could be in the Navy. Somebody could also have a tattoo of some wings, okay? You and this person may... you and this person may have a connection back to ancient Egypt. Somebody also may be drinking out of a wine glass or some type of chalice. Somebody could have a particular glass that they drink out of. You're treating yourself as the king or the queen that you are. And that was a side effect of what you experienced within that partnership. Now, the individual that you are dealing with, this person could be around the age of 37, give or take 7 years. Somebody is also born in the 90s, 92 to be exact, or 93, okay, like I was saying earlier. But this person is searching for you. They're looking for you. They're hoping that the two of y'all cross paths again, or there's some type of way that they'll be able to connect with you. You focus on closing deals. Okay. PA could be significant. For some of you guys, I do feel as if somebody is having to keep something censored or watch what it is that they say. Maybe you feel like that, especially with that throat chakra. This person could have even made you feel like that at one point in time, like you had to walk on eggshells. You had to be careful with what it is that you said. But the pressure produces diamonds. And that diamond, you are. Now here you are, you're successful, celebrating, making the most of every opportunity that you get. And this person, they see that peace that you have. So some of you guys are going to get some type of message from somebody. This could even be a DM. Okay. But somebody feels like they can't come back. And maybe you've made that very clear with your actions. You or this person could definitely be utilizing public transportation, or somebody could drive for public transportation. The flow of the conversation between you and this person can be very poetic at times. For some of you guys, you could actually be a poet. Flowetry, baby. Hello. Somebody's rocking a lot of bracelets, big earrings. For some of y'all, they missed the conversation y'all used to have. Your first love. Gucci could be significant. You could be rocking some Gucci, or this person could even have some Gucci sunglasses. You could have experienced a lot of first in your life with this person, first experiences, or for some of you guys, this person could have introduced you into that Kundalini awakening. They may have even introduced you or reintroduced you to loving on self all over again. Your first love, baby. Avon and Kiki. One more song and we're going to get into it. So you will always have a part of this person. You and this person will always have that moment. That moment that y'all shared together. Now look, they can be very possessive. Tank, you belong to me. Okay. So they went to telling you that you they first love. They got these feelings. Next thing you know, your ass belong to them. Okay. Just saying, your person a little cuckoo for Coco Puffs, boo. Let's see what's going on with them. Hold on. Let's get these cards. Well, I can tell you one thing. They don't know what the hell they doing. Trying to be patient, baby. So somebody is trying to manipulate this situation. They may be trying to take advantage of this situation. Maybe you felt like this person took advantage of the relationship, even in the past. Okay. I do feel as if somebody definitely has a lot of pressure on their shoulders to apologize. Okay. Apologize for manipulating you. You feel like they owe you an apology. Maybe you even feel as if this will definitely show some type of growth. Okay. You know, for you, it's like, if this person could apologize, I would definitely know that they've grown. But I do feel as if for a lot of you guys, you have grown from the grief and the sadness. Didn't I tell you? The side effects turned you into a savage. But there's this pull. There's this codependency when it comes to this connection between you and this person. Okay. So what's going on? Who's looking for them? Let's start there. Who's looking? Okay. A wild card. So this is definitely not something that you're expecting. This situation can play out, okay, any kind of way. This is going to change the dynamic of things, the way things go from here on out. Okay. So you never know what to expect when it was dealing with this person. For some of you guys, hell, you may have even bought your own deck of cards and started pulling just to figure out the individual. Because they were so unpredictable. For some of you guys, especially if you have your own card, somebody may be getting stuck. Because it's not, it's like you may be trying to read further into the future and it's not meant for you to know. Mm-hmm. Who looking for them? Okay, somebody that you've separated from. Now, the feminine energy could find herself living in the past. Even if you're not dealing with somebody from the past, you may find yourself revisiting feelings, emotions from the past. Masculine energy definitely is ready to move forward in his life, and he may realize that he's going to have to separate from somebody that he has some type of history with. Okay. For some of you guys, you weren't even expecting for you and that person to separate. It just happened out of nowhere. Okay. So this person has definitely, it's like this person has been up under some type of illusion. They're searching for some type of fulfillment. Maybe they thought that they would be fulfilled without you. You could be born between the 26th and 30th of the month. Somebody could have thought that they could have did better without somebody. Because somebody was too unpredictable. Somebody could definitely be a dreamer. And they may lack the action that goes with the dreams that they may have at times. It's like somebody is chasing some type of euphoria, some type of high in life. This person may find themselves escaping mentally at times. And the fact that you aren't able to predict each other's behavior could be why the relationship separated. Neither of you wanting to show those emotions. But there's this contract between the two of you. Love. Somebody's in search of love. Somebody could even be addicted to love. This masculine energy may be addicted to love and not even know that they are addicted to that nurturing energy or that need to be nurtured. Somebody is drawn to somebody's light, their aura. You could even be seeing orbs. What does she go to? This masculine energy, he's still trying to put the pieces together. What did this feminine energy walk to? What does she move towards? Okay. A situation that caused you to be triggered. Okay. There's a need for you to set some type of boundaries. You're attached to a situation, especially if this is a feminine energy. If you are a feminine energy, you're attached to a situation that you need to establish healthy boundaries. Okay. There may even be a need for you to learn to establish healthy boundaries. So this masculine energy is addicted to love. This could even be somebody who's a breast man. Okay. Bottom of the deck, sparks. For some of you guys, you could have went back to a situation where this person could have empowered you, made you feel good about yourself, even though you knew that the relationship wasn't good for you. This could even be a friendship. Okay. You have assets. So material possessions, that could be a challenge. Somebody could have also separated because of that, because of the lack of security that they felt from the relationship. Okay. You could be dealing with a Scorpio. Okay. You could be a Scorpio. All this person needed or needs, they feel like they need, is going to be an opportunity. And you have Taurus. Okay. Somebody is looking for some type of opportunity. When it comes to some assets. Okay. You have foreign travel. For some of you guys, this could be foreign to you, dealing with this type of situation or dealing with this type of individual. I do feel as if this has sent you on your spiritual quest. Okay. Didn't I say 92? Okay. Somebody could also be dealing with a Pisces. You could be a Pisces. Okay. So somebody could be taking somebody's key. Somebody could have also lost some type of key. This could be like a key to a home or a vehicle. Two different people, neither know what to expect of each other, and separation. One looking for the other, looking for where somebody could possibly stay. This could be through assets, especially if you have assets with this person. Okay. This is somebody who's deliberate, okay? Deliberately doing something. Person could be very possessive, okay? What's this wild card? Wintertime could be significant to the situation, okay? Somebody could be welcoming something in. So, wild card, okay? Some things being kept on the down low. Somebody's also keeping some type of assets that they have on the down low. Okay. Somebody gonna try to pull somebody whole card. Uh-huh. Somebody could be 52. Somebody could be 52 and on the down low. That's not for everybody. Somebody's looking for an opportunity. Okay. Here, somebody is not paying attention to the synchronicities, that they may need to detach from a situation that lacks boundaries. Because if there were boundaries, somebody wouldn't feel triggered. Okay. So you're having to change your outlook. Somebody is too busy focusing on the fact that there is a separation, and they're not focused on the messages and even synchronicities that their ancestors are giving them. It's like you could feel like because you're bummed out about your situation, it could even be assets, things like that. Okay. You're not paying attention to the spiritual messages that you may be getting from your spirit team. You see the number synchronicities and you don't even take time to follow up with it, because you want direct answers. But it's like you don't want to communicate with them, but yet you are asking them for the answers. They're communicating. You just have to learn how to communicate the way that they do. So somebody has a lot of secret sexual desires. Okay. It's like that could definitely be the euphoric feeling that this person is in search for. Deep down, this person may not know what it is that they want. But this person is wanting to overcome some type of obstacle when it comes to love. This person may have a hard time being loyal when it comes to their relationship because of all of these secrets that they may be keeping. What they truly want sexually. Somebody is keeping lovers on the down low. Okay. Some of you guys, you may have been questioning somebody's sexuality. Now, this feminine energy could have went back to somebody in the past, may even be ignoring red flags. But there's boundary issues. You got somebody want, but they want somebody to commit. Commitment material. Somebody may need to remember that they are commitment material. And need to set boundaries in their relationship. Look at this. Yeah, because this person is going to fucking trigger you. Okay? They're definitely going to have an impact on your relationships. Especially if this person has secret sexual desires. They could definitely have a STD. Okay? Bottom of the deck, you have spell work. Somebody could be doing some type of attraction spells. So somebody's keeping some stuff on the down low. Somebody's also hiding some assets. Give us three cards for their romantic sector. Show me three cards for the romance for them. Okay, security. Sex could make somebody feel secure. It could make this person feel secure about themselves. That may be how they cope with things. Okay, the masculine energy. This could be something that they're keeping a secret. And this could even be the amount of it could even be the amount of individuals that they've had sex with. Somebody has had sex with up to 900 people, honey. Somebody lives a fast lifestyle. could be very reckless. Okay. So the best part. So this person could bring you some type of security, or you bring this person a sense of security. And that's the best quality that maybe this individual has. Okay. Now, you've had some vivid dreams pertaining to this individual. For some of you guys courting this individual, there's this strong attraction between you and this person, even to the point to where they show up in the dream state. Okay. I feel as if they could be showing up in the dream state to either provide you with some type of sense of security or letting you know about the relationship attachment. Bottom of the deck, soulmate. So you're separate from your soulmate. Both of you guys are apparently dealing with other things. Both of you guys are keeping these things on the down low. Your person is having to deal with, the masculine energy is having to deal with secret sexual desires, overcoming those obstacles when it comes to love and sex and distinguishing between the two. The feminine energy, she may have went back to some of her old habits or ignoring the red flags, number synchronicities, okay? But she's definitely attached to a situation that causes her to be triggered. She's committed herself to that, and it's definitely having an impact on her health, whether this is STD or not, honey. Because everybody, I know all y'all ain't walking around here like that. So I know that this has to have, whatever you're going through, it has to have some type of impact on you. But yet you're not able to detach from the situation. For some of you guys, you're changing your focus when it comes to the vaccines. You could be triggered by this. Okay. Not really sure if you want to commit to this. Some of you guys having to deal with some type of boundaries. But it's like two individuals, separate, both having secrets, keeping secrets from each other in order to distract you. Both of you guys are trying to distract yourselves with other things. And you've done that since the two of you have split up. Now this person wants to find you because, even if it's in the dream state, because you bring them a sense of security. They think about all the times when the two of you used to date each other, court each other, where there was that attraction between the two of you. They think about all the fun times, the best part of the relationship. But somebody may feel as if the other person is going to be able to read them energetically if y'all come back together. Because both of you have your own shit that you have to deal with, your own secrets. Somebody also has a sleeve tattoo or a tattoo on their hand. Okay. Show us more. Somebody is dealing with the masculine energy who's bald head. Okay. He could definitely have some secret sexual desires. Okay. He's between the age of 30 and 40. Somebody's name is Todd. Okay. And look at this. Hypersexuality. So hypersexuality is an issue in the relationship for this masculine energy. It says the obsession with sexual thoughts, urges, or behavior may cause distress affecting the relationship. And that could have been what separated the two of you. It's because this person is always preoccupied with thinking about sex, looking at Instagram models, okay, online, dealing with different apps, or just over-sexualizing individuals. It was like they were desiring things that maybe they felt like they couldn't open up to the individual that they were with. Yeah, this person could have been afraid that you were going to belittle them or make them feel or even look stupid. Somebody could have even done that, come across as being a little judgmental when it comes to sex. Okay. So this person tries to play it safe when it comes to how they express themselves. Okay. Out of fear. Okay. This person is confused. They confuse sex and love. They feel like sex equals love. You know, this person, they also don't like the fact that maybe you put yourself out there. Okay? Maybe you're very expressive with how you feel. Somebody is very opinionated. And, you know, they could feel like you always want to act like a doctor and pinpoint what's wrong with them. You know, how can they come to you and be honest with how they truly feel? Okay. This person has definitely mourned this situation more than you know. They've struggled with getting rest. Rest when it comes to the spirit, the soul. Honey, I just heard literally the soul is weary. Oh, goodness. You and this person could have been married. You could have even had a family together. More towards the end of your marriage, y'all could have been sleeping with y'all back towards each other. But this person is no longer confused. They see what the issue was in the relationship. Maybe this person feels like they didn't put in enough time. Maybe this person feels like they were too concerned with their phone, okay? And both of you guys were living separate lives, even with the connection. Both of you guys texting other people. Till y'all finally got tired and stopped texting each other, stopped talking to each other. But that doesn't stop somebody from watching, especially the feminine energy. She tries to act like she doesn't. She tries to act like it doesn't affect her. But, and fuck could be this woman's favorite word. She could always be like, fuck, fuck. Okay. You and this person, y'all are definitely in sync. Y'all will look at each other's stuff at the same time. Like, this person is holding on to this. Somebody holds on to stuff. They may take stuff to the grave, honey. The feminine energy could come across as a little immature at times and flighty. And here both of you guys are separation. This could have been a husband, okay? For some of you guys, this is your divine counterpart. But this person, it's like chess and checkers. You're trying to play one game and they're playing another. And TLC, waterfalls. So somebody's chasing waterfalls. This person definitely watches you. Very handsome, nice looking individual. This person could like to wear the color black and red. Huh? Somebody's colors are that color. I was about to say somebody's sorority colors. This person looks very good in red. You could be an Aries or dealing with an Aries. But here this person is. It's like they holding back. They feel like they have to hold back. This person does feel as if you may watch them. They feel like you may watch them closely. Now, if you're dealing with the Aries or you are Aries, somebody could be dealing with two different women. There could be a woman who has some blonde hair or lighter color hair, even honey blonde. And then a woman who has some black hair. Knight of Wands, didn't I? Oh, Knight of Wands, King of Wands. Some of y'all are dealing with a fire sign. You know, this person is definitely free-spirited. Huh, and TLC, Waterfalls, that song. Definitely check it out. Don't go chasing waterfalls. You may make this person feel insecure at times. This person could be, they could be a cusper. You could be dealing, again, with a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Aries, Leo, Sag, but definitely an Aries, okay? This Aries is watching somebody, or this person, you were married to this person, or this is your divine masculine. But this person is not speaking up because they know that they have some type of sexual addiction. Somebody's got some green hair. And somebody also drives a black Wrangler or a truck. This person may feel like they need to overcome some obstacles on their own. But in the meantime, they're definitely keeping an eye on things or trying to keep an eye on you. Now, this feminine energy. Okay, Ten of Swords. It's like whatever situation she's dealing with, somebody's getting a divorce. Whatever situation that this woman is dealing with, it's like it is a situation that she's going to have to eventually let go of, because she could potentially even be holding on to some type of disappointment. Somebody married a con artist. Queen of Swords in reverse. Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. You're not cutting a situation off. A situation that you know may not be healthy for you in the long run. Inwardly, you know you need to cut a situation off. Definitely make sure you wear condoms. Set boundaries with this individual, because if somebody went back to somebody, that person could have an STD, honey. Yeah. And they're not telling you about it. Okay, so for my ladies, if you happen to go back to somebody from your past, be careful. Because that person may not be telling you that they got something going on. Look at this bottom of the deck, baby, tower card. Okay. And look at you, you dropped your guard, your defenses. Okay. Thank you guys so much for your love and support. But yeah, make sure you wear condoms. Okay. What is happening with you and your person? The separation. I mean, what? Like, they looking for you. But yeah, somebody's got somebody's name is Givens or something. Givens. So, ego. Okay, bottom of the deck, optimism. It's hard for you to be optimistic when you're dealing with somebody's ego. And, you know, this person hasn't even made the attempt to go and get any type of help. This masculine energy with whatever addictions he may have. Okay, Knight of Cups. Look at this. Somebody got some friends, bitches, hoes, and bros boosting their ego up. Okay? And that could be the issue with the two of you truly establishing something in the relationship. Okay? This person got too many people on their coattails right now. So don't look like nothing gonna be popping between the two of y'all. Okay? And look, that's their Ten of Cups right now, baby. Let's get y'all song headed up out of here. Escape, baby. Work me slowly. Y'all have a wonderful Friday night. I will see y'all at the event. for the Halloween specials. If you are partaking in that event, head over to the website, boo, and go and get your spot. If you're interested in checking out our VIP and extended, as well as your November monthly messages, head over to the website, boo. Go on and pour you some wine. Now here the person is drinking to cope with their emotions because you're spiritually protected. Leo energy. Mm-hmm. Let's see what signs this could be. Give us the top four signs. They could be doing the witch's brew. Okay. You have Scorpio. Okay. This is somebody that's very passionate. You have a Taurus. Okay. You got a Capricorn. And our last one. Okay. There's no balance. Oh, goodness. Okay. Somebody's also, they opened up some type of portal. The dream state could be significant. There's no balance. Okay. Yeah, somebody's allowing something in. Okay. And you got Pisces. Okay. Pisces did it for love. Okay. Yeah. They in their feelings. They want somebody to surrender. See the bigger picture of things. They want an Aries to surrender. Okay.
They had sex.